Okay, in this video, we want to discuss how to apply the technique of synthetic division to divide one polynomial by another polynomial. It's a very handy technique under the proper conditions when you can use it, and unfortunately, it is very restrictive as to when the technique does apply. For example, suppose we had a polynomial like this, x cubed minus 6x plus 4, and we wanted to divide this polynomial, say, by another one, x squared plus 15x minus 47. Could we use our technique of synthetic division to carry out this? And the answer is no. We would still have to go through the long division process. Synthetic division is restricted to these kinds of circumstances. Suppose we had, again, our polynomial x squared minus 6x plus 4, and it was divided by x plus or minus some number here. Then we can go ahead and use the technique of synthetic division. If this was x plus 7 or x minus 3 or x plus 2 or x minus 17, this general form here, then we can go ahead and use the technique of synthetic division. So it is restrictive when you can apply it, but still it is very helpful, particularly in cases where you have a very complicated polynomial and you want to try to determine what its prime factors are. Let's see, suppose we just had our original polynomial here, x squared minus 6x plus 4, and we're going to divide it by x minus 3. The first thing we have to do is rewrite the numerator. The way we have it expressed right now is, this is x to the highest power, minus, and then we have our x to the next highest power, plus 4 times x to the 0. What we have to make certain that we do before we go ahead and apply the method is, start with x to the highest power, then you want to have x to the next highest power, one less than that. And then you want to have x to the one next to that power, one less than that, and so forth. So we would rewrite this as x cubed plus 0 times x squared, because there's no x squared here, minus 6x plus 4 divided by x minus 3. So what we've done is, this is our highest power of x. Right next to it is x of the next highest power, this minus 1. There's no x squared here, so we just put down a 0 for its coefficient. Minus, now we want x to the first power, there it is. And next to that, we want to have x to the 0 power. There it is. So now we're ready to go ahead and apply the technique. And what you do is you write down the coefficients of these different x's. So let's see. We're going to have 1, 0, minus 6, and plus 4. And we want to divide this by x minus 3. Then what we do is, whatever number you have here, take the negative of that number. This is minus 3, so the negative of that would be plus 3. And you write that number down here. And underneath the second number here, to form this column. And after that, you just add and multiply. 0 plus 3 is 3, times 3 is 9. Minus 6 plus 9 is plus 3. 3 times 3 is 9. 4 plus 9 is 13. And that's it. We're finished. So what does this mean? At this point, we take our first number and write that down. Now, in our original polynomial, 1 was the coefficient of x to the highest power. Now it's going to be the coefficient of x to the next highest power. So this will be the coefficient of x squared. And this will be the coefficient of x. And this is our new constant. In this polynomial, the constant was 4. And this number here is the remainder. So what this means is that x cubed minus 6x plus 4 divided by x minus 3, that will equal 1 times x squared. So we have x squared plus 3 times x plus 3 plus 13 divided by x minus 3. And that's it. So when we can use the technique, it's very simple to apply, very rapid. But like we say, it's also very restrictive when you can use it. Where it is most useful is if you have a complicated polynomial and you want to determine what are its prime factors. For example, when we're dividing this by x minus 3, suppose that we had 0 for the remainder. Suppose this was 0. So this would not be here then. What that means is that this would equal this times x minus 3. So then x minus 3 would be one of the factors of this polynomial. So if you're going through this process, and for the remainder you get 0, then you know that this right here is one of your factors. Of course, here we did have a remainder, so this is not one of the factors. But let's see if we can determine what the factors are that for this polynomial. So let's move along. Would x plus 1 be a factor? So that means we want to take this down, divided by x plus 1. Write down the negative of that number, and write it down here. And then add and multiply. This is negative 1. 0 plus negative 1. This will be plus 1. This is going to be minus 5. This will be plus 5. That's going to add up to 9. You know right away, this is not a factor. So move on to the next one. X plus 1 is not a factor. What about x minus 1? So here then we have x minus 1. Over here we write plus 1. And we write it down here. And again, add and multiply. 1 times 1 is 1. Minus 6 plus 1 is minus 5. Times 1, this is minus 5. This is minus 1, that's not 0. This is not a factor. Okay, ignore it. Move on to the next possibility. What about, say, x plus 2? would x plus 2 be a factor? So we take negative 2, write it here, write it here, add and multiply. This would be minus 2, times minus 2 would be plus 4. This is minus 2, times minus 2 is plus 4. That adds up to 8. That is not a factor. Discard it, move on. See, x plus 2 is not a factor. What about x minus 2? We have x minus 2. Here we write plus 2. Down here, write plus 2. Add and multiply, 2. 2 times 2 is 4, minus 2. Minus 2 times plus 2 is minus 4. Add these, we have 0. This is a factor. So, x cubed minus 6x plus 4 will equal x minus 2 times what? Bring this down. This is not a factor of the coefficient of x squared. This is the coefficient of x. That's our new constant, so it's time. This times x squared plus 2x minus 2. So you can see that using synthetic division can be very handy when you want to determine prime factors of polynomials. X minus 2 in this quadratic term doesn't look like this can be broken down any further. So here we have this polynomial expressed in terms of its prime factors. So that is kind of how the technique is applied. Come back and join us for some more videos, and we'll see if we can tackle some more complicated examples using it.